Hi and welcome to TEC Pipe Parts. Today we're going to be fitting our new X Pipe Decat unit. Now this unit will fit all of the modern water-cooled twins apart from the scrambler, which obviously got a high level exhaust on it. Now before we fit it, we're going to do a comparison of before and after with three different types of exhausts. We're going to do it with our slip-on mufflers, the standard mufflers, and the aftermarket Triumph Vance & Hines mufflers. So we'll do that test now. So this is the bike running without the X-Pipe fitted and TEC slip-on cans without baffles in. Right, now we have the standard Triumph Street Twin silencers without the X-Pipe fitted. Right, now we have a noise test of the Triumph aftermarket Vance & Hines pipes, slip-ons, again with the X-Pipe still fitted. Right. Why, you may be wondering why you need to fit an X-Pipe to a bike. The main reason is that the catalytic converter is very restrictive. It stops a lot of the noise coming out of the exhaust and the energy and causes quite a restriction in the flow. Now, by putting a pair of aftermarket slip on this exhaust, you won't gain much power because of the restrictive nature of the cat. Now, we've done a lot of testing. We've taken a while to get ours to market because we didn't want to rush it, we want to get it right. We've done a lot of work with Triumph dealers and dyno work to get this absolutely spot on. Now, we've looked at some of the X-Pipes on the market and we've found that the flow isn't quite right on them. Some of you use a straight-through pipe from here to here with a link in. Now, you don't get very good torque with that system and you don't get a very good flow, but they're cheap to make, so that's why they do it that way. Also, a lot of the ones that come out of Australia don't have any mounting to the frame. So this thing's just hanging there in mid-space, which is not a very good engineering idea because you're relying on the exhaust pipes holding them in place. So you're putting a lot of load on the graphite seals that come out of the exhaust. Not very good engineering practice, and I think we'll probably see a few failures like that. Also, it doesn't line the pipes up very well. So as you can see, ours mounts to the frame. It also takes the standard heat shield as well, so it's good for disguising in markets where this isn't technically legal. So for all points and purposes, if you look at the bike, it looks totally stock. Even if you use the standard silencers in markets where you have to, you're still going to retain all your legality markings on the silencers, yet get a bit more performance and a bit more noise, which is what I'm sure everybody's after. Now, again, looking at the pipe, most of the pipes on the market use stock bends. Now, that's fair enough, but to get the best performance, we've found that this area here where they're welded together is critical. There had to be a certain dimension to get the right amount of torque. A few millimeters difference here makes a big difference in torque drop-off. So, and also, by using stock bends, you have to put an extra piece in here, which means more welding. Now, we've used CNC specific bends for this purpose that are welded together, and the way you can spot our X-Pipe straight away is there isn't two welds across here. Most of them on the market have two, and that's because they're using standard off-the-shelf bends. Again, it's down to cost. Now, talking about cost, why would you buy one from us? Well, one of the good reasons is ours is half the price of anybody else's on the market at the moment. The only one that's anywhere near it is a mild steel chrome plated one. And I'm sure you agree with me, underneath the motor getting covered in muck and salt and water isn't an ideal environment for a chrome plated piece of mild steel. Ours is 100% stainless and it's guaranteed a lifetime. So you have a problem with it any time in your life of the bike, we will replace it free of charge. Right, now we're going to show you how to fit it to the bike. It is quite an involved process. It involves loosening this side frame rail from the bike to get the old cat out and to get this one in, because it's actually slightly wider than the frame rail, so you can't get it out of the bike. So to necessitate that, we obviously need to take the exhaust system off both sides because we're going to need to reconnect them to this. And we're going to need to just loosen this side. You normally get away with just leaving this hanging here and just loosening everything off. The only reason you're doing it is to get this out. So it's just a matter of if you can wangle it out. And I'm going to show you, hopefully, a few shortcuts on how to fit it. Okay. Right, a quick word about how to work on the bike. Now, if you haven't got a center stand fitted, it's going to be a bit awkward. Now, you're going to need to go off, obviously, because you're taking the side frame rail off that takes the side stand. So you can't support it on the side stand. You could use a paddock stand like we're using here, but the bike doesn't have spools on. Now, we do a little kit that allows you to mount spools on, which is very handy for situations like this. And just obviously make sure it's nice and firmly supported and it can't come over on top of you, because it's quite a dangerous thing, a bike, when it's up in the air. Right, so to take the exhaust system off, first need to remove these little heat shields either side that disguise the fact that the exhaust system's actually in two pieces. And that's just done with an Allen key. I'll just show you on the one side, and I'm going to bore you taking both sides off at the same time. Now, there's a little clip on the top that just pops out when you unscrew it. And then they just pull off like that. Now, you can see there's a couple of clamps in here. And you just need to loosen those off of the socket and loosen the silencer at the back here. And there's also a separate mounting on this side and the other side at the middle here. And once you've taken those off, you can take the back part of the exhaust system off.
I assume this is blocked.
Yes, that's just blocked.
Because it sort of looks like you've cheated.
It would be nice and noisy if that was left on, yeah. Right, after having done a few of these, I found a few little shortcuts that you can make life a bit easier for you. When you loosen the front pipes off, just loosen them off. Don't take them completely off. And remove the clamp part that goes around the lambda sensor and just slip on the bottom part back on again. And it keeps the pipe in place, saves you having to disconnect the lambda sensor, and the pipe will just hang there and it'll be out the way for you. You can still get in. Do that both sides and it saves a bit of messing on. So next you just want to remove this bolt from the top of the radiator, so you can just maneuver it a bit so you can slip this pipe.
Just show him where the bolt goes.
In that hole.
Oh, right, yeah. Got it.
Maybe I'll take the spacer off in case you lose it as well. And the radiator's just held on a little peg here at the bottom. Now, what we need to do now is loosen this bolt here in the frame. Remove this engine bolt here, on just the right hand side one.
Engine bolt, yep.
And remove these two frame mounting bolts from the back here. Now, we're not going to take the frame rail completely out, we're just going to leave it hanging in space, because all we need to do is just wangle it out a little bit. Okay, so we'll loosen those off now. Handily on this one, there's a little welded in plate with two nuts welded onto it, which also holds a sump guard if you've got one on. Now, just watch this wire in here. Just make sure you've pulled through a little bit of spare. If you want to take this off, you'll have to disconnect the wire in, which is just behind this panel here. But we normally just leave it in place. Right, so it's just the engine bolt to go. Okay, so we've removed the bolt from the front of the engine here. We've taken the one out at the top and these two out here. And as you can see, it's all loose there now. And with this front pipe loose and just hanging there, we've now got enough room in to get in and disconnect the cat. So we need to disconnect this bolt here, and there's one on the front as well, and then we can wangle it out. It's the two bolts undone, so you simply pull the cat down and then slide it out of its peg on the other side. And that's the unit there, which is quite heavy.
That's the
peg, the rubber peg that goes on the other side.
Okay.
So you just simply remove all these fittings from it. And you need to take the guard off as well. But we'll fit the new cat in first, and then we can transfer the clamps and that over. So put a bit of silicone grease on the pegs, just to make sure it helps the rubbers all go in a bit easier. And then we need to take the rubber out of the front here. And just pop it into the hole there. Just make sure that's in properly. And that's it, ready to fit there now. Actually, I was going to do a little comparison on weight between them. Do you want to feel the weight there? That's your cat.
Crumbs.
I'll just stick them on the scales and we'll see what the difference is.
I'll say about a quarter of the weight.
Right, so first of all, the cat on the scales.
261.2.
Grams.
No. Sorry.
That's grams. 261.2 grams. That's 2.6 kilograms. The X pipe, which weighs in at 728 grams.
Crumbs. So the X pipe is a third of the weight, more than a third of a weight of the original cat. Excellent. Less weight, yeah.
It's
more speed.
Approximately 2 kilograms lighter.
Is it best to put the heat shield on first or afterwards? Or does it not
matter? I find it easier because you can get into this bolt to put it on afterwards. But it's up to you whether you want to do it or not. Because this little bolt can be a bit of a swine to get in.
That's the heat shield coming off the old.
Yeah. Got two little rubber pads that go under those prongs there. So now we can reinstate the frame rail. So you just need to put that bolt in there just to locate it for now. But you also need, what you need to do is, okay, I think we'll have a bit of silicone grease on there. You've got to make sure that the radiator locates on its peg as you slide it up, which is one of the, that's it. On the back. And we'll pop these two with a little locator plate on the back. Back in. Now all these will need torquing up again, but I'll give you the torque settings at the end of the video because I can't remember what they are at the moment.
But I would have thought it'd be a good idea to leave them slightly loose until you.
Yeah, you can get to all of these. You can get to all of these and go over check everything at the end. Yeah. Now the top one's a little bit fiddly. Now a little trick here is, luckily the nut that came off has got a shoulder on it, so you can put it into a spanner like that, feed the spanner up and get it through. It's a little bit of a awkward one, and I'll probably swear when I'm doing it. Okay. So we just slip the pipe onto the bottom first, and then it slips into the head. And it's just a matter of putting the two collets back on the right way around. So that little tab on there, it's got to fit in the slot where the bolt goes. We'll wait to put the silencer on the left side because the silencer has a tab to locate it on here to keep it in the right place. So I'll just use the side stand to keep that up there. And we'll just lightly tighten it up for now. The front pipe can be tightened. And it's so you just, once you've got the two pipes on and tightened up, you can reinstate the heat shield and just make sure it's all lined up properly. Right, so here we are now. We've got the straight through Vance and Hines cans on with the X pipe fitted, so this should be a bit louder than before. This is with the X pipe fitted and the standard Triumph cans on, so it should be a little bit louder. Right, so this should be the loudest combination of the X pipe Decat unit in and the TEC slip-on silencers without the baffles in. This is the TEC slip-ons with the baffles in and the X pipe fitted. Right, so that's it all fitted there. It's taken about an hour and 10 minutes with our little time-saving dodges. The one thing that I should have done that saved you more time is to fit the clamps and the sealers on the cat pipe before putting it in. they're a bit fiddly to get on once the cat's in there. So just do that before you go in. As you can see, it looks very stock underneath. There's no way you could tell it didn't have the cat in place. Now, a lot of people ask why you need an X pipe. Now, we've done a lot of testing on these bikes. We've made front pipes up that just flow right through, and it absolutely kills the torque of the engine. You actually need a good balance pipe underneath to help the flow and the torque of the engine. So it is a necessity to have something under there. And also, by having an X pipe like this, it looks stock, it looks legal. So you shouldn't have any problems with insurance companies or the police if you did have an accident or whatever, or you need an MOT. So there you go.